G'day guys, welcome back to another midweek episode. Today we're going to be reviewing the BFG KM3 Mud Terrain tyres. Done 40,000 on these tyres, so it's about time we did a review on them. So let's get into that. When we were choosing a tyre to put on Percy the Prado for our lap around Australia, there was a few things we had in mind: strength, durability, and longevity. So you don't want to be getting a tyre that you're spending $2,000 on for a full set and then wearing out in 40,000 Ks. So we went with a pretty reputable company in BF Goodrich. And the reason why we went the KM3s over the KM2s is pretty much for looks. I really like the look of them, and I did hear a lot of good reviews about it. If you put the reviews aside, BF Goodrich are a very reputable company, and we wanted to make sure that we chose a reputable company to have on Percy the Prado for our lap around Australia. So the size of these tyres, guys, they're a 285/70/17. Got them on a 17-inch rim, zero offset, and obviously you've got your Toyota 139.7 PCD. These tyres here, guys, have, like I said, have done 40,000 Ks. I have a little confession to make. I haven't rotated these tyres since I bought them, so I've been super lazy. I haven't rotated the tyres, and they're still wearing super good. So the backs, obviously, are going to look a lot better than the fronts, but in the backs, I'm still getting about 30 mil of tread still on the tyres. I'll show you guys the front tyres now. So the front tyres, guys, are faring pretty good as well. These still got 20 mil tread on them. Very happy with the overall tyre wear. And like I said, I haven't rotated them. The spare's still brand new on the back. And these tyres have never moved from where they are now. Another thing I want to talk about, guys, is when you're selecting a tyre for your four-wheel drive, I seriously recommend looking at getting light truck tyres. These tyres will specify LT just before the size of the tyres specified on the sidewall. The reason I went with LTs is because they've got a thicker ply sidewall, and they're also thicker all round. So pretty much they're a more durable tyre. It won't matter if you get them pinched on rocks. They're less likely to break, and they also bag out a lot better. So when you bag a tyre out, you want the tyre to go that way rather than that way, because you're hanging out the sidewall if it balloons out the side. So when you're dropping your tyre pressures to go on the beach, guys, these tyres are outstanding. They go that way and they don't balloon out the side because of the thicker sidewall. So that's another reason why I went with BFG KM3 tyres. A little story I have is one day I was dropping my tyre pressures down. I dropped them down, went on the beach, didn't pump them up, went straight home. The next morning I woke up, came outside to get in the car, and I noticed one of the tyres looked a little bit flatter than the rest. What had happened is I had a leaky valve. The tyre actually pretty much fully deflated. To that point I didn't really know how much PSI was actually in the tyre. I got my tyre pressure gauge out and I did put it on the tyre, and the tyre was reading zero PSI. So they were completely flat and it didn't roll off the rim. So that's a testament to how strong these sidewalls actually are. And that's why I'm giving them such a good review, because I reckon I could have driven on that tyre and yeah, it wouldn't have come off the rim. So that's how low you can drop it, guys. I dare say if it wasn't the front tyre, the back tyre would have came off the rim, just because there's a little bit more weight in the back. That's pretty amazing in itself. So a lot of people ask me, aren't the BFG KM3s noisy because they're so aggressive? And I straight away tell them that I had the KO2s, so the all-terrain version of the BFGs before these, and they were worn really badly. So they were a badly worn all-terrain tyre, and I reckon the well-worn BFG KM3 is the same noise as the KO2 that was poorly worn. So yeah, they're not that noisy, guys, and I can honestly only hear the turbo and the exhaust, and that's about it on the highway. So the exhaust drones out the tyres anyway, so that pretty much sums up how noisy they actually are, which is bugger all. Definitely recommend getting the KM3s if you're worried about noise. They are a soft compound rubber, and that's why I think they're so quiet on the road. They do pick up a lot of rocks though, guys, that's one thing I will say. They do pick up the rocks and chuck them, so a lot of the times we hear rocks hitting the caravan. Luckily we've had rock tamers, but yeah, so that's the only thing, guys. They do chuck rocks around, but apart from that, I can't fault them. They're great tires, and I'd recommend them for anyone that wants to go off-road with their four-wheel drive. So thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you in the next midweek episode.